My name is Eddy Chavez, and I help in the production team in the Aurora campus. I was born and raised in Mexico, in a city called Toluca. My mother was the first one who recognized Jesus as her savior, and that happened when I was around 14 years old. So she became Christian first, and then she started praying for me. It didn't matter what time it was, during the morning or night, she was always praying and crying out to God for my safety. I discovered alcohol at an early age, and I think I really liked it, and I got hooked to it. Most of the people that I was hanging with, they were older than me, and they were involved in a gang, to be honest. And I witnessed a lot of things that I am shameful for. I felt in that moment that I was by myself, and they were a family that I was looking for. But I believe that today, if God didn't show up in my life when he did, I will be either dead or incarcerated. There was no other option for me at the moment. When I was 21, I was in college already, and I said to my mom, hey, I'm going to school, I'll be right back later. But I was lying completely to her because I had another plan. I was going with a friend. I remember I took the car, we started driving. I was speeding, and the car crossed in front of us with no warning. This car just went through the red light. It was catastrophic. The car was completely destroyed. It flipped over a couple times, and if you see the pictures of the car, you will think that everybody must die. But by the grace of God, nothing happened to me. I stayed alive. It was just a miracle. And I think in that moment, it's when really my heart and my mind changed and say, this is real. I realized that I couldn't lie to God anymore, that I could not keep living my life the way it was. God is real. God is here. God saved you. Look at the car. Look at the mess. And look at you. After that, I start going to church more often, and I start trying to follow Jesus, reading the Bible, helping as much as I could. And that's when I started doing production. Pretty much right after I moved here permanently, when I start going to another church. And I remember it was an Easter service, and the production level at this church, it was mind-blowing. And somebody actually told me, hey, you know what, you could help them. And I was like, are you sure? Yeah, you could help production if you want to. So that's how I got involved in production, and how I got into a small group, and how my community started building around Christian people. In May 15th of 2015, I got really, really sick. I got a really strong pain in my belly. And the last thing I remember is my coworkers, or my brothers in Christ, were around me trying to help me out, and they called an ambulance. I was in a coma. They didn't know what was going on with me. They couldn't do a lot of tests because my illness, it was so severe. They were counting the hours. They were telling my family, we don't know if he's gonna survive tonight. We wish we could assure you something, but we really don't know. After 3 months in the ICU and 6 or 7 different surgeries, they were able to remove some pancreatic cancer that I had. I remember on the really, really bad days, me asking God, why are you letting me leave if I'm gonna be this way? It's not easier if you take me home. It's not easier if you end this right now. But I believe that God always have a perfect plan for everybody. And he gave me a second chance, a second opportunity to redeem myself. God did really a miracle in my life, because I don't depend on any medicine to survive. And the cancer is gone. I am in a better place now. I'm not gonna say that it's gonna be a miracle like flipping a switch, because it's not. It's an everyday effort. But God is always there. God is always listening. God is always loving you. Even today, you know, when every single time that I feel the wind in my body, I am reminded that God exists. I don't see the wind, but I feel the wind. And it's the same with God. I don't see him physically, but I feel him in my heart. I am very thankful to God that he always gives me a second chance, a second opportunity to redeem my faults, even to this day.